press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Dear students, so in circles chapter under exercise 10.5, so far we have completed 9 problems. Now I will take up 10th one. So please open your textbook, page 186. So 10th question, if circles are drawn taking two sides of a triangle as diameter, so you can see here ABC is a circle, triangle, ABC is a triangle, and so AB side of the triangle is the diameter of one of the circle. And AC side of the triangle is the diameter of the other circle. This condition is given. So prove that the point of intersection of circles lie on the third side. So the third side is BC. We have to prove that the point of intersection of these two circles. So that is point B. Point B, point of intersection of two circles lies on the third side, that is BC. So that is the condition. So exercise 10.5, question number 10. The given data is two circles are drawn taking two sides of a triangle as diameter. So given triangle ABC and AB is dia of one circle, and AC is dia of another circle. Now, to prove the point of intersection, say circles intersect. So I will write here circles intersect at A and B. Circles intersect at A and B. To prove point B, that is the point of intersection of circles, lies on the third side, that is BC of the triangle. That means we have to prove that So this is, they are intersecting at A and D. We have to prove that BDC. Or that is BC of the triangle BCC. That means BDC are collinear. collinear. This is what we have to prove. See here what we take the contention. First we will take that it is not on BC. So by contradiction we will prove that. So I will write in the bottom, let answer let these circles intersect at point D. Point D. Let us presume that D is not on BC. Let D is not on BC. We will presume the contradictory version. First, we will think that it is not on BC. Now, see, AB is the diameter. Since AB is diameter, since AB is diameter, ADB will be equal to 90 degree, because ADB will be equal to 90 degree. Reason is angle in the semi circle. Angle in semi circle. So similarly, if you consider AC diameter, AC is diameter. Therefore, you can see ADC is also equal to 90 degree. The reason is same, it is angle in the semicircle. So this is the diameter, therefore this is semicircle. The angle formed in the semicircle is 90 degree, therefore this is also 90 degree. Now I will erase the top portion. So now ADB, so therefore ADB, therefore ADB, ADB plus ADC, ADC is equal to 90 degree plus 90 degree, that is equal to 180 degree. So when the angle is 180 degree, we can say these two are linear pair. Therefore, ADB and ADC are linear pair. Therefore, we can say BDC, BD, point B, D and C are collinear, or D is on BC, side BC. So this is the proof. So now we will erase this, we will proceed with the next problem. Now, question number 11. ABC and ADC are two right triangles with common hypotenuse AC. Prove that CAD equals CBD. Now, so I will draw the figure. So now, two right angle triangles are given. ABC is a right angle triangle. So I will write a right angle triangle here. Join this. ABCD. Now, so ABC and ADC are two right angle triangles with common hypotenuse AC. AC is the hypotenuse. Therefore, this angle is given as 90 degree and this angle is given as 90 degree. Common hypotenuse. This is the meaning. Prove that CAD equals CBD. CAD, this angle. We have to prove that this angle is equal to CAD equals CBD. These two, we have to prove that these two are equal. This is the question. Now, let us proceed like this. Given ABC equals ADC equals 90 degree. So that is given there. Now you consider triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, the sum of three triangles ABC plus BCA plus CAB. BCA plus CAB equals 180 degree angle sum property. Angle sum property. So ABC is 90 degree plus BAC plus CAB is equal to 180. is equal to 180. So from this we will get, transfer this 90 that side, we will get BAC plus CAB equals 180 minus 90 equals 90 degree. So you can call this as equation 1. See, from the triangle ADC you will get a similar equation. So in triangle ADC we will get a similar equation, that is ACD plus similarly in a triangle. So ACD plus ACD plus, this is 90 degree, therefore we have to take sum of these two, DAC, this angle and this angle is also equal to 90 degree, call this equation 2. Now we have two equations, so add 1 plus 2, so if you add left hand side and left hand side, BAC plus CAB, BAC plus CAB plus ACD plus DAC is equal to 90 plus 90 right hand side, 90 plus 90. BAC plus now observe here, so we have BAC and DAC, you consider the first and the last, BAC and ADC, so BAC plus CA so ABC plus BAC, this is ACB, so BAC plus CAB, okay. So with this we will get BCD, observe this, BCD plus DAB is equal to 180 degree. Now, so this implies this, the sum of two will become single angle. So what it indicates? This is angle C plus total angle A is equal to 180 degree. Angle C plus A is equal to 180 degree. So in any quadrilateral, if the sum of the opposite angles is 180 degree, then it is cyclic. So we are asked to prove that CAD equals CAB. So therefore, we have come to the conclusion that this is a cyclic quadrilateral. So therefore, because of this result, therefore ABCD is cyclic. ABCD is cyclic. So now, when it is cyclic, considering CD chord, so I will write at the top, you cannot be visible for you. So we have proved that it is cyclic, so therefore ABCD is cyclic. So now consider CD chord. So if you consider CD chord, the CBD angle is equal to DAC angle. So these two are equal. So this is because angles in the same segment. So this is what we are asked to prove. These two are equal. Hence proved. Now, the question number 12, the last question in the exercise. Prove that a cyclic parallelogram is a rectangle. So we have to have a cyclic parallelogram, and we have to prove that it is a rectangle. So I will draw a cyclic parallelogram. Parallelogram is one which is having two pairs of opposite sides parallel. ABCD. So question number 12. Given ABCD a cyclic parallelogram. To prove ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is rectangle. Now, proof. So, it is told that is a parallelogram. So, ABCD is a parallelogram. So, we know that in a parallelogram will be of this shape. You remember? It may be, of course, a rectangle is a special type of parallelogram. So, in this, opposite angles will always be equal. These two will be equal and these two will be equal. That is one of the basic property of the parallelogram. Opposite angles will be equal. So, therefore, and so now, it is a cyclic as well as parallelogram. Cyclic means the opposite angle sum should be 180 degree. So, ABCD is a, I will write cyclic parallelogram. When it is cyclic and parallelogram, they are opposite angles are equal as well as sum will be 180 degree. 180 degree sum because it is cyclic, equal because it is parallelogram. So, therefore, opposite angles will be equal and also supplementary. Supplementary because it is cyclic, equal because it is parallelogram. Therefore, A plus C is equal to 180 and A equals C. B plus D is also equal to 180 and angle B equals angle D. So, by the word cyclic parallelogram, we will get these results. So, therefore, if I take this equation, A plus C equals 180 degree, C is equal to A, therefore, I will write A plus A equals 180 degree. Therefore, 2A equals 180 degree or A equals 180 by 2 is equal to 90 degree. So, in a parallelogram, if one of the angle is 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. So, final conclusion, in a parallelogram, if one angle is 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. therefore ABCD is rectangle. ABCD is rectangle. ABCD is rectangle. So, dear students, so we have completed all the problems under circles chapter. Some of the basic things you have studied in this chapter. So you understood what is the definition of a circle, what is an arc, so what is the radius, what is the diameter, what do you mean by a chord, and what are the angles subtended by a chord at the center and in the major segment, minor segment, major sector, minor sector. So all these basics you have learnt in this chapter. This is one of the important and major chapters in your syllabus. Please go through all the videos once or twice. Note down the notes systematically in the chronological order. You see the videos second time in the sequential order, then only you will understand the entire topic. So I hope you will work at home and be safe. Thank you, students. So this chapter is over. I will take up the next chapter in the one more chapter in the next class. Thank you, students.